Good evening. My name is Uma Rani. I'm the Senior Vice President responsible for maintenance and support at SAP. I've been there for 18 years. Some of you might have interacted with me long ago.
Thank you. Your mic might be working as well, right? So can you just make sure that his mic
works? Good evening. I am Deepak Agarwal. I'm General Manager with Indian Oil Corporation.
Looks like the mic is not working.
Okay, this is Deepak Agarwal. I am from Indian Oil Corporation Limited. Basically, I am in the ERP group of Indian Oil Corporation. And it's a centralized architecture which we handle through Gurgaon data center.
Okay, thank you. So this session alone is going to be slightly different in terms of the format. So we'll have Deepak actually present what they are doing in order to leverage the enterprise support services that SAP offers. And post that, we'll have a quick round of discussion with maybe both Deepak and Uma. So Deepak, if you could just take it up.
Okay. So what I am basically trying to show here is not what ERP we have done, basically how the enterprise support services and the CCO certification, what we have achieved, how it is helping us in achieving our journey as well as the innovations. Company is well known, I think, no introduction needed, but just for information, the 30.5% of the refining capacity, we own about 10 refineries out of 12 refineries in India. We have got 11,000 kilometers of pipeline, and if you look at the 48.2% market share in the downstream sector, about 39,4,000 touch points are there. And we operate SAP basically from the 800 locations, and we have got a people say Indian Oil operates SAP at the highest altitude, basically at Kargil. So that kind of a distinction what we have got it. If you look at just at the business technology here the actually demand starts, how to predict the demand, right? And we have got the supply chain management systems in place, and then we have got a production schedulers, all LP models at refineries, where to transport, what to process, what crude is to be bought, which refinery will do what, this gets covered into the production. And then the supply, basically we have got a SAND model, supply and distribution model, again an LP model. So this demand, production and supply, this is being handled by the different group through the LP model. What SAP does here is basically the business. So for the last, I think we went live in SAP in 2003, and you can just imagine what kind of a data we have accumulated in SAP in the last 15 years, right? Just to show you, look at the business magnitude, what SAP business magnitude, the mind-boggling figures actually. So if you look at the FI documents, I mean, lakhs, it is in crores. If you talk of purchase orders, it is in lakhs, right? I mean, look at the magnitude what IOCL operates from 800 locations. This shows basically how complex will be the thing. Now here the enterprise support system comes. If you look at our sales, we sell 1 crore rupees of product per minute. So that's basically the question here is how to maintain your system so that you are not even losing a sale of 1 crore rupees. So point here is generally people ask us what kind of a ROE you are getting from enterprise support services. I generally answer them. The entire turnover of 4,60,000 crores is the ROI on enterprise support services. Why? Because a minute downtime, I am losing 1 crore rupees. So if each minute passes out very successfully, system is operating, I am getting my ROI on a day-to-day basis. This is a technology blueprint what IOCL made in 2012, where we said vendors, suppliers, customers, investors, they will come into our systems through a secure data and network layer interface. And we had three kinds of system, SCM, what I talked to you about, central ERP, and then value-added legacies. And that time we thought we'll just have the applications framework will be e-commerce, mobile application, portal, knowledge management, and all those things we'll do onto that. But today, if you really look at the new things which are coming to this, this is the total digital transformation, right? And frankly speaking, I'm telling you very, very frankly, we have not done much on analytics. Though we have got 15 years of data with us, we have not done much on analytics. We have not done anything on cloud. IoT, we are very, very much interested. We have already started a talk with enterprise support people, like they are creating a value map for us. If we do an IoT, this is one of the deliverables, right? What enterprise support service gives for us. So we have taken out this project IoT. We will chalk out something, what we can do in IoT and can take it as a POC, how the technology works. Social also, we are talking to them, but there are so many different tools are available. Let's see, but IoT and analytics, these two are the, I mean, things which we have taken with ESS Group. Mobile, yes, we have done something onto that. I'll just show you. This is our total SAP landscape. You have got an ERP here, and this is Solution Manager. Why I'm talking Solution Manager is entire ERP operations. We have done a lot of good things in Solution Manager, and I can bet for it, some of you will be really astonished what we have done on Solution Manager. We have got an entire terminal automation system. All of our terminals, all of our tank farm systems, they are directly connected to SAP. Each and every transaction is happening over the wire. If a truck goes, truck comes, all these transactions through an LRCS systems that come automatically on the SAP system. You have a portal. Somebody was asking travel, leave application, other things, kind of things. This enterprise portal takes care of about 65 employee self-services for 35,000 employees. So this is kind of a magnitude is there. Again, if you look at medical, TA, numbers are really huge. So very, very important landscape for us. This is integration technology, PI. I proudly say we were the first one in the industry to make use of process integration. Now there is a different name for it. They call it process orchestration, PO they call it. SAP really helped us to streamline this PI process. If you talk of TAS, if you talk of mobile applications, we take it through the PI route actually, right? Then you have got the Fiori applications. We have done one launch in Fiori. And right then, first of all, what we do with the SAP enterprise support is every April we meet and we decide what we are going to do in a year. We make out our entire plan because we have got some national holidays, 15th August, 2nd October, and 26th January. All these three national holidays are fixed for upgrades and doing some innovative work. So we sit with SAP, what kind of a thing we want, what I should do, they make a roadmap for us, they tell us how we are going to help and all those kind of things. So we are already on EHP 7, we are already on Oracle 0.4, 26th January we are upgrading it to 12C, and Solution Manager we have got in two instances. We are on 7.1, I don't know how many people are on 7.1, but if you look at 7.0 and 7.1, lot of difference between 7.0 and 7.1. For example, if you talk of ITSM, all ITSM features are available on 7.1. Dashboard if you want to make it, right? Beautiful dashboard you can make it. What basically enterprise support people, they came us and they are helping us in making those dashboards. Those are available on 7.1. So what we have done, we have segregated two Solution Manager. One is totally for the incident management, where the users are logging their complaint. And the second system, we have kept it for technical monitoring. This is how we have made our landscape, right? Then we have got a process integration, 7.4. Enterprise portal, we are going to upgrade. It is now 7.3. I think shortly we'll be upgrading it to 7.4. There are a lot of good features in 7.4 enterprise portal. Look at the growth performance. I was talking to you 2002. Look at the way the data is growing. At this particular 2015, it was 17 terabytes. Single Oracle database, 17 terabytes of database, single instance we were having it, right? But somehow, we kept our performance at the same pace. Why? Because we got it invested more and more in the hardware. Database was increasing, we were investing in hardware so that at least the response time doesn't get through. Then what we did, we had a discussion with SAP enterprise support people, how we can bring down this data down. So what we did, we executed a very ambitious project called Database Reorganization and Compression Project, right? We did a reorganization as well as a compression, both the things we did. And this database came from 17 terabytes to 6 terabytes. You can just imagine, we were having 7 instances of database because we have got 3 sites. One site is Gurgaon, then we have got a near recovery site, then Bangalore is our disaster recovery site. So 7 instances, so 17 into 7. So this kind of things were there. Once we did this project, it took about 2-3 months. A lot of issues came. Enterprise support people gave us a lot of inputs into that, how to do, what tables can go correct, what we should do, what are the various steps onto that. And then finally, we did it very successfully. It came to 7.0 terabytes. This is our SAP operations, what we do. In each and everything, look at this database size, 6.4 terabytes. We have a uniform response time of less than 1 second. we have 15,000 users. Our user base is 15,000. And at any time, specifically right from 6 o'clock to 3 o'clock, you will find at least 6,000 to 7,000 users already logged in. Night time only aviation works, all aircraft and all those things, then it comes to about 100, 200, 300, 400. Otherwise, 6,000 consistently you have the users on that. Still, we are able to maintain the SAP response of less than 1 second, right? Then you have got the user messages. So many messages comes to us, our shift people, they handle all those different password change, this change, those change, authorizations, all those things they handle. Backup time, which used to be 14 hours, it has come to less than 4 hours. Right? So this is what I'll say, the DROC project, what we did with enterprise support. I don't know whether Pramod Verma is here or not. He was our basically offline consultant. He really told us a good tips to execute this project. Look at the growth. I was telling you the users were increasing, and SAP response time, constant. So this cannot be done, you know, all those things. You need certain SAP nodes. You need to have what is to be tuned. So we've got a good data bank of all SAP nodes and other things. You just fire an OSS message. And I mean, within 1 or 2 days, I mean, if it is not a very high message, you get all very good relevant nodes. But the person who is doing, he should be very passionate. Because a single node will not give you the entire thing. Within node, you have another node, until and unless somebody takes an interest, somebody is passionate about it. But definitely, I'm sure, if you follow their nodes, and most of the time, SAP even doesn't know they have created a node. Right? We tell them, look, this problem we have found out, our people have found out, this is the node, next time somebody asks you, give him this node. So this is what it happened. But SAP has got each and every solution in the form of nodes. So don't depend on SAP. I mean, we also do all of nodes and other things, and we do that. This is our daily snapshot. Right? This is basically what comes to my table in the morning. And while I go home about 7 o'clock, again, this snapshot is sent to me. It gives me the entire history of what is happening into my system. Number of data files, DB response time, how many SAP users, all those you will get. How many dumps are coming, right? And how many, this thing, ST22 dumps are coming. All those things you will find it here. Similarly, for my XI system, XI means I'm talking of process orchestrate. How many messages have been sent, what all is happening, how many while exchanges, SMS, indenting, and this is all my terminal automation system, how much data is in, and this is my enterprise portal. So each single chart, we do it. But how to do it, how to link it, definitely ESS, I mean enterprise support people, they tell us. So they tell us how to, you have to connect to the database files, which will give you all this information, and then we make a board like this. If you look at operational excellence, at least I believe in this thing. I don't know about others, I believe it in. Documentation is the very, very important point. If you look at SAP, I think masters in documentation. You pick up any documentation of SAP, such nicely written. So we follow them. What we do is, if you look at this, we are ITSM certified, we are business continuity certified, we are security certified. All these three certifications are with us. Why? Because it helps us after every 3-4 months to revisit our documents, what we have done. Somebody comes, challenges us, and we take a corrective action. Right? Otherwise, people generally, you know, technical people are very, they will just do something on the computer and keep it here and then get lost. So all those things we have, all operation manuals, everything is being kept into that. And 24/7 monitoring of performance parameters we are doing. We are doing high availability and environment audit, even SAP enterprise support system, once in a year, they do a high availability audit for us through early watch report, right? This is upgrades. This is one of the very, very good enterprise support services delivers. At presentation level, whether it's, I mean, SAP GUI, application level, and database level, all these three upgrades today, if you really ask us, we are as per the SAP roadmap. Where SAP has left, we are there, right? Except HANA. That's a different story, but EHP 7, Enterprise Portal 7.4, PI 7.4, technically we follow that. Functionally, yes, there are some certain problems because we have customized too much as well as in our sales, so we are not able to take the full advantages of all those things. This is what our database and reorganization project, the figure it gave us to us. Database says 62% reduction, DB response time 35, storage I have 70% came down, and SAP response time 33%. It's a big thing, huh? 50, pardon? Without? Yes, yes, sir, without us. See, we started doing archiving. Very, very good question you raised. SAP has got a very good service called continuous quality checks. If you take their DVM service, I mean, they give you a lot of input onto that. So we were not satisfied with that. We call them on site. I said, you come here for 2 days, sit with us. We want to see what we can do in archiving. So what they did basically, they pointed out, out of the entire database, there are only 10 tables which are growing. Wo ISEC, VSEC, ko pata nahi kaun sa table tha. Those 10 tables were going to increase. Right? So they say there is no need to touch the tables. So entire archiving, if you want to do, you do from these tables. Then there is another problem. If you ask any user, I am doing an archiving, tell me what is the retention period, he will just, I mean, go away from there. Nobody wants to make a commitment of things. So we started, it was giving some, and FCD server, we don't leave it, not giving rock particularly, not that is without archiving the archive now, right? This is the upgrades. Again, we are totally dependent on SAP Enterprise Support Services. We are on, we are totally now ready for GST. Already some specialized, I'll call it, workshops at our site has been done by SAP, how to migrate to GST, and
have done one feasibility study, ready basically, ready for, whether are you ready for GST or not. So one kind of a study has been done under Enterprise Support Services, and but we already have done, one was EHP 7, so we migrated to EHP 7 on 15th August. We are planning on 26 January, Oracle 12c, and then we are planning another implementation called Oracle ADG, Active Data Guard product we are going to implement it, because today what we are doing is our disaster recovery sites are working on redo log files. It's a shipping of redo log files, right, between Gurgaon and Bangalore. So we want to take this product, which has got a, which is a very nice product. I think our RTO and RPO will come down very, very heavy. These are the value services from SAP. At one particular time, we never knew what is Fiori. We were confused, what is Fiori, what it is, what they're talking about and all. I mean, they gave us a lot of literature onto that. The thing which we came to know on Fiori is basically through the webinars. I mean, every month we get a calendar, what are the webinars are going to be telecast on enterprise services. And we have already dedicated a room and a team, right? They sincerely attend each and every webinars and make a note and give a presentation to the other team. So this is how we learn about the Fiori. The next implementation, what we are thinking is with the help of enterprise support is SOA implementation. Today, if you talk of, we are heavily dependent on RFCs today, and which is not a secured way to do the transactions. So we are planning to shift on SOA. So we are just taking from, so that every, each and everything can be as, published as a web service. Right? So this is, we are working on to that. Already SAP Enterprise Support Services, they have done a feasibility study for SAP HANA. We have taken a decision. We are not going to shift on any HANA appliance. Straight away we'll shift to S4 HANA. Right? So after 1 or 2 years, we are already started working on to that. They have still not come out with all the modules on S4 HANA. I think within 1 year they will have a full stack available, and maybe 2017 or 18, as a big bang approach, we'll shift to S4 HANA architecture. This is our first Fiori implementation. I heard somebody was, HML, my colleague was telling on ESS, or for employees they have done it. Similarly, we have also done on Fiori. It is on furniture, holiday list, off-cycle payments. You know, every second day or fifth day you get some payments through SAP payroll and all. So people get all this information on off-cycle, how much the salary you are getting, some important fields which are very variable, not dynamic, the variable fields we are showing it here. Employee search, LFA details, and your nomination dependents and leave balance, all those things. Actually, we announced this application with the view that all wives who are basically habitual of looking into the husband's mobile, they should know what are the things which are important to them. For example, whether my husband has declared me as a nominee or not, how much pay packet he is getting, what is his LFA due, so that they can plan next holiday. So our chairman announced that way. So it is not for the employees, but this is for the spouses, actually.
So bank balance is one thing.
So, I mean, we had our Indian Oil Day on 1st of September, and I was really surprised when chairman said, I have got a good gift for the spouses of my Indian Oil employees. He says, kindly look into the mobile of your all spouses. There is an application for you where you can get each and every detail about it. This is somehow something very good. We have done it, location department head search. Now, there is no need for directory. If you want to search 800 locations, who is the head of the locations, who is the department head and all, This information we are driving from where? SAP HR organogram structure. Right? We are using the OM module very nicely in SAP HR. Total our workflow system. We were not very sure about the workflow system. Again, we got good inputs on workflow system. And through that, we are heading, I mean, you can find it out. Suppose if I'm in Ahmedabad, I want to know who is the head of the Ahmedabad state office. I'll just go to this, find his number, address, everything will come and I'll contact him if I need some help. So this is our Fury implementation. This is another application. We had four mobile applications, all flavors are different, right? But frankly speaking, not because SAP is sitting here, we like the way Fury application is coming. The tile-based system, and very nice to implement, I mean, as far as it is the SAP database. This is our Empower. This is again for the employees. Employees means for our sales officers, because generally they don't sit in the office. They are always mobile between the retail outlets, 1 to 30 on the highways and all. So whenever they go to any retail outlet, that owner asks him, what is the status order? How do track the sales, how much he has done these sales and all. So this particular application is talking to SAP at the behind, right? And we are giving the access through the NetWeaver gateway. The point is, we are using NetWeaver gateway here. How to exploit it? Again, the enterprise services. They have told us how to make use of NetWeaver gateway services, and we have taken the licenses also for NetWeaver gateway licenses. Third application is XSpersh. This is for our dealers. They want to know what is my balance, what I paid, when I picked up the product and all those things it is happening, and we are bringing them through the route of SAP PI, right, into our system. This is how it is happening. This is another application, fuel@IOC, right? I suggest you all should download this application onto your mobile. What it does is, if you're on a highway, and it will scan your location and it will tell you within 9 or 10 or 15 kilometers which are Indian oil retail outlets near the vicinity. What kind of a services they give you, whether they have a washroom, whether they have an air machine, whether they have got a medical facilities, what is the price of the fuel there, all those things will be given to you. This particular application we have done on Oracle MAF, Mobile Application Framework. So that's why I was telling you all these four flavors we are available there. Unicode, we are taking it very seriously with enterprise support services because we were busy with, because what they told us, as I told you, our yearly plan, they said while doing a Unicode, you need a lot of space, a lot of storage is required. Why? Because the bytes will expand, right? Unicode, once you write it, it takes a lot of space. So first you have to make a provision of this space here. So that you have already done it. Now we'll be taking a Unicode project with enterprise services, as I told you, S4HANA. So these are the two very major projects in the last 2 years we have already talked about with enterprise support services, how they are going to help us. SAP Personas. Has anybody laid their hands on SAP Personas? My friends from HMEL. Very good utility. We have done already some pilot testings. Beautiful screens. This is the original SAP screen which looks like, and you can customize the screen the way you want it. This is Personas screen. Right? You can do a lot of things. You can aapko ghoda dodana, kuch karna, whatever the things you want to do it. Beautiful screen, Personas, you can have it. Why? The other person, it is not dependent on you. The user, if he is intelligent, he knows how to do it, he can customize his screen in his own way. Right? So this is the Personas testing we have done it. So we will be launching it shortly. As I was telling you, automation, all tank forms, tank trucks, lorries, weigh bridges, lorries, everything is connected to SAP, right? So if you look at, this is the thing, a lorry comes here and the fan is already made by SAP. There is a RFID device, it tells you which way you have to go, it checks the truck's condition, whether it is a right truck or not, all those things, it directs him which way you have to go, how much KL is to be poured into the tanks, all those things, everything automatic. Trucks comes back, the moment it comes to the gate, it takes the invoice and goes away. So there are 100 such terminals which are totally automated, and except the security person at the gate, you don't require anybody. So this kind of automation we are doing it. So why I'm talking of automation, today we thought ERP is very, very important for us, but what is happening is all these allied services, you know, if this is down, you can't operate your terminal, which is basically the actual location of sales. Sir. every truck? Are you really sure?
Yeah, 100%.
They take give 5 rupees only.
500 rupees.
500 rupees. Okay.
Even though there is a leakage of the this is petrol or diesel, once it go to the dealer side, see there is always shortage.
Good. There are certain measures. I'll not go away from this answer. I mean, as far as the truck inside the station is concerned, everything is all right, right? The moment it goes out, there are two kinds of a thing. Whether the truck is of IOCL or not, or the owner has sent his own truck. If owner has sent his own truck, we are not responsible for it.
Every personal truck, whatever they registered with the, they are registered with the IOCL.
So those
trucks are registered with the IOCL.
How to check it in SAP? I don't know. So if somebody is taking a bribe, what can I do? But we have a system here. I'm just telling you. I think it is in the slide. We have already started determining what used to happen is every truck driver wants to make number of trips in a day, right? Because he will earn more. And if he gives 500 rupees to somebody, as you are telling, I will not say yes. So he gets two or three trips. So what we do is now through a GPS system, we are finding out whether the one truck has reached there or not. So SAP system automatically checks whether he has done one cycle or not. Then he will not, his name will not be announced. Whosoever is in the vicinity of 500 meters in the yard, the other truck who has not done the trip, he will be called. This thing is also happening in SAP in 100 installations, right? So, but
even though whatever the services think, you told here, just a minute. Have you seen any of the scheme of the dealer that is offering to the dealer?
Yeah.
Have you gone through any of the scheme?
Yes.
You just go and then input the data and then see what the result comes.
This is my experience. For LPG or retail?
I got an opportunity to taste an order.
Mm-hmm.
I did not take it. You just see the data, the kind of data they are fetching.
I think, guys,
there is some issues. That's why I'm saying, because you are the related to IT, if the service can be offered, if a layman can operate a system.
Dealer doesn't have access to SAP.
They have the access.
No, they have been provided. We have given them mobile. What they will do with SAP?
They have to log into the system and take the data.
Maybe you are talking of LPG then.
I'm talking about the, there's a petrol and diesel.
No, they don't.
They have the username and data?
No. They don't have system, no retail outlet person, they can access to my SAP system. Otherwise, I think we take this off. My license will go beyond 50,000. I'll be the most profitable company for SAP in the entire world.
They have been username and password.
Maybe they must be entering in some legal system.
Accessing their invoices and punching
the order. That is not SAP, that is a retail dashboard, I mean, which is a legacy system. I was talking to you, supply chain, ERP, and value-added legacy. So this is a legacy system, all those things. But just let me tell you, we are already working onto it. Maybe within 1 week or second week, one tender is coming, we are going for a CRM. We are going for a CRM project where LPG and retail outlet, everything will come.
I have seen the same scheme that you have told three, four applications.
We are veering off topic. I think we should continue. So if you want to have this conversation, you can have this one-on-one.
I take.
So, in the interest of time, let's please.
If you look at this B2B scenarios, why I'm talking to B2B scenario is I'm talking the SAP PI. The way SAP PI needs to be cut, what is the power of the SAP PI? When this product was installed, I am telling you very frankly, even SAP was not knowing much about this product. So both of us, they co-innovate each other. We set together how to do it, what to do it, how we can potentially use it and all. And if you buy this PI product, it is the license matrix is number of CPUs, right? But when we bought it, it was on a number of data basically, which gets transferred between the two systems. So we have taken PI that time. So both of us did a lot of hard work onto that and we got it stabilized. Why I'm telling you is oil exchanges, I told you, this is the hospitality account between BPCL, HPCL, other things. They also have a SAP system, we also have a SAP system. So both the SAP systems talk to each other. One raises the invoice here, one raises the intent there. This is how both the systems talk to each other. Similarly, with other parties, we do have. This is our SM indenting system. Nobody needs to come to our petrol pump. All dealers, distributors, through an SMS, a fixed format, they just put this SMS. It gets converted into the XML format. It comes to SAP via PI route and gets converted into IDOC, and his indent is created. So this is how we are using this system. And e-payment and e-collection, 4,50,000 crores is our turnover, means my e-collection. Entire money is coming to us through wire, through these banks, right? So this is why this PI has become such a lifeline for us, I mean, all those. That's why regular upgrades, patch, other things are very, very important onto that. You have to, once it is so important, you have to do a PI monitoring also. Earlier, these monitoring tools were not available. With the help of enterprise support services, we got these small dashboards made, and I can find out what my servers are doing, what is the load, and whether something wrong is happening on the systems, I can find it out. And similarly, you know, all this load and other things I can do. Similarly, for EP monitoring, enterprise portal, 36,000 employees, round the clock, because once you're in night shift, he's also putting his medical bill, all other bills onto that. So we also measure how the EP things are monitoring, whether CPU utilization, DB monitor, request per second and all. This is enterprise portal EHP, what do you call, 7.4, right? This is the thing, if you look at, this is a broadcasting sign. We were really facing a lot of difficulty in our ESL services. If I want to tell my employee tomorrow, kindly put your conveyance claims because the financial year is ending. There was no way to do it. So I was not able to broadcast anything onto my enterprise portal. So we took up this thing with SAP, right? And they took some time, and finally in 7.4, they have come out with a feature of broadcast. So if I am a user, I have logged in, if there's a broadcast, this particular sign will come. I click it, I see what is there for me, I will see to it. They call it operation control center. Have you seen it? This is what we are going into this direction. We have already done a lot of work onto that. Now finally SAP is going to create a dashboard cockpit for us, not under consulting, under enterprise support services. I'll show you some screens. This is the cockpit will look like. We have already seen a lot of screens, entire technical monitoring through the dashboards. You can monitor it. You can go drip down, drill down, drill down, drill down, drill down, and you can go to the final, what is the root cause, some problems are happening. Entire status of technical monitoring you can do through this, through graphs, through pictures. So this kind of a things which we are doing it, I mean, SAP has done a lot of, enterprise support has done a lot of work with us in set, they are going to set up because we have to buy monitors and how, what should the shape, but all diagrams, all graphs are already available. This is solution manager, yes, ABAP system integration, all ABAP information you get. Earlier, there was no Java integration. In 7.1, now you can monitor your Java systems also because your enterprise portal is in Java. So this was the system which was getting ignored and I was not able to add any value to it. Now you can find out why the Java system is not behaving properly. I can drill down, all those things I can do. So this is one of the good advantages here. The service delivery, yes. Technical dashboards, as I told you, some of the screens here, but these are very less. But if you really look into it, it looks very beautiful. If somebody can come to our office, we can show it to them. Another thing is license management. I don't know about others, but I say very proudly, we have no compliance as far as the license numbers is concerned with SAP. The solution manager is helping us basically to have the license management and all. Every quarterly, we run the law report. Earlier, we used to do in USMM. Now, we have been told law report. Every quarter, our group, through solution manager, they generate the law report. We send it to SAP. Some question happens, matter closes. Once in a year, final audit happens. For the 3 years, it is happening. Comfortable life. Right? This is, I mean, the most of the important thing in 7.4, we are doing a license management. We are CCA set up recently, I think 3 months back, we were certified fourth time for CCOE. Now, why I was talking to you, CCOE is basically, it really helps us to set the house in order. It's an 800 locations office, right? And somebody in Gurgaon, they are doing a lot of modification to the system. How that modification, for example, what happens? In my head office, somebody says, purchase order, may I want this particular facility. Right? He is a head office person, somebody does it.
Now, how to percolate it to the all the locations, look, this particular facility has come into the purchase order now. Or these are the new things which we have brought. How the information will flow down the down the entire organization. So CCO is basically one of the things which helps you in managing your information and keeping all the users well informed about it. There is a system for it. So our CCO objectives, I told you, we do some consultancy also, especially for oil and gas, this thing. This is our CCO organogram. We have a head, functional head, technical head, two different functional people by this, technical by technical head. And this is what I was talking to you, the internal marketing. Now, you are doing a lot of work. 15,000 users are there, you are running SAP, business is running, all those things. But how do you know whether user is happy or not? This is one of the elements of CCO. They say we want to know what customer think about you. And this is really every board wants to know about it. So we have taken some, through SAP we are doing some user satisfaction survey. Information sharing, very, very important thing for us. How does any changes in the system you do it, how does it reach to the people automatically? We do information sharing through this particular model. Central documentation, you are making functional specification, you are making a lot of documents, operation documents, a lot of other things I'm making, where you should store. How the people know, how should I get, where will I get, whether I'm authorized to do it or not. This is our CCOE homepage, right? If you go into on the first page, they will get SAP documentation. Further drill down, there are different categories into that. Each and every SAP document is getting stored there. We are using SharePoint portal here. We are using Microsoft SharePoint portal as these things. Entire our knowledge documentation, we are not doing very high-fi kind of things. We do certain announcements and we do maintain entire documentation into this particular folders. And everybody knows where I have to go, what I have to pick. I mean, well-informed people. Now, one is the customer satisfaction survey, but we have started a new thing, the information sharing, right? What we do is, we have made very nice tool, for example, in MM, logistic knowledge awareness queues, material, engineering, inventory, plant, and all those things. What we do is, we pick up the sample database from the authorizations, what authorizations you have given. So what we do, from this authorization, we came to know 9,000 people come under this category. And we have made a quiz here, which basically talks of all new things what you have done in the last 1 year, right? If you go further, it will tell you like this. Functionality of document management system is available in SAP. He will say yes, he will say no, he will say not aware. If he will say yes, answer is yes, no issues. If he says no, answer is yes, once you finish the quiz, it will tell you are wrong, it is there. If he says no aware, it is a matter of concern for the central team, it means you have not propagated the ideas down the scene. So we accumulate all those things. It is available for SD, MM, HR, and this thing. This is how we take the surveys. Look at this. Way bill monitoring system, preferential market access. You know, PMA, you must have, I think, hardware ki aaj ki rate mein aapko MSME and made in India. All those provisions has to be brought into the system here. How much we have done it. All those things are available here. So this is how people, we select our these things, whether you are a material person, engineering services, inventory, plant, or others, whether you are intent raising. He goes, clicks, answers, and we get the feedback out of it. So this is a part of the CCOE. This is, I was telling you, in SAP, doing this satisfaction, that was whether the people know it or not. Second thing was, are we doing our job properly or not? This is how the users, they give a response. There is a SAP where we have written some programs and we announce we need your survey and then the survey results comes. For example, somebody says FI outstanding, so many percentage. Yellow, very good. Good, poor and all, those kind of rating analysis and we analyze why it is happening and all. So in normal life, you will not do all those things. So who forces you to do this? CCOE. So CCOE basically helps you to keep all those things in order. This is our, if you look at the message handling, about number is 1480, right, in 2015, and we are, all SLAs we are monitoring through Solution Manager. As I told you, in 7.1, you have a facility to define your incident management and your all your SLAs. So you can do root cause analysis, we are doing, and we are using maintenance optimizers as others are doing, but we are using it religiously. I think today it is not allowed also without maintenance optimizer, you can download this software. Charm is the thing which we have not done so far. Very shortly we are going to work. Why? Because we want to target onto the secondary CCO certification which nobody in India has achieved so far. So we are targeting secondary CCO certification. Nobody in India has achieved so far that certification. This is how our support desk works. At locations, you have people. Then there are state offices, first level support. If they are not able to solve it, then it comes to our central desk at Gurgaon. We have a development request coordinator, because who tells you? See, this development request is something like that. Somebody says, oh, our development request bhejna, fraud bhejna, mera problem ho gaya, and all those things. No, there is a coordinator for it. Whether there is a cross-module things or not, there is a process defined into it. This is what is the advantage of basically CCOA. And no request we take into the morning time, into daytime. All requests go in the night time, right? Until unless some very, very emergency is there, three people have to sign there. Yes, this request can be taken into the during the daytime. Otherwise, everything gets transported. So why? You have to define a procedure. Who forces you? CCOA forces you to basically how the development request should be done. A single person is responsible. When a development request comes, he decides whether it is a cross-functional or it is only a unifunctional. If it is unifunctional, he passes out. Otherwise, he talks to the two, three people differently. Have you tested? And other things, and then you go further. How many people use Solman for testing purposes? Nobody. We use it. Each and every test scenario of each module, we have defined into our SAP system in Solution Manager. We didn't know about it. These guys helped us. Each and everything, whether green, whether it is passing or not, entire documentation, all those things kind of things. And because we are doing so many frequent upgrades, the first thing when an upgrade exercise happens, everybody updates these testing requirements. So we are using Solman testing tool for our testing scenarios. Because so that I can also see in SD, there were 40 scenarios were to be tested. How many have passed? How many have failed? What is the status? It is not like that somebody gives me a mail, Mr. Agrawal, SD is cleared, I am going home. You release the system. No. You have to give me a dump. You have to show me whether all those tests have been passed or not. So we use very rigorously testing processing. CCC elements, as I told you, these are the pillars for CCC elements, and that really keep your house in order. Change request procedure, very, very important. We follow it. Information management and contract administration, right? So, and these are all these things. And another three is security and authorizations. I don't know how many of you are aware. There's a very good CQC services on security optimization. Have you run the CQC services? SAP gives under the enterprise support services a bunch of CQC services, right? About, I think if I'm not wrong, 15 or 20 services are there. And it's a pain because you have to get yourself involved, and there is no value addition for the management. You have to do it for your housekeeping and all. But once a year starts, we sit with SAP and we say, in this month, I need CQC for data volume management. I need CQC for HANA testing. I need CQC for security optimization. Like this, we define our 5 or 6 goals. This is what we do on security. It definitely adds values, as you can see, common business process, structured procedures, and we are able to give 24/7 support, constant optimizing with business processes. If you talk of enterprise support services, we have got a very, very, I mean, old relationship with SAP, 15 years old. Now we are very, very far ahead than incident management. Incident management toh chal raha hai, toh chal raha hai, right? This is a 15 years old thing we are doing. Our relationship has gone this thing. We are making good use of enterprise services in accelerated implementations. Optimize IT operations. The example I gave you is my solution manager dashboard, technical dashboard, means the control center of innovation we are talking about. Partnering in innovation, as I told you, 2 or 3 things we did with them. Fury we did with them. Upgrades, regular and legal and regulatory, and health checks and reports. Tell me very, very honestly, how many have you read the early watch report sincerely each and every page? Just raise your hands. Read it. You will love what SAP is. Read this report early watch. They do a total post-mortem of your technical systems. Beautiful report. We run it as a service after every 3 months to see what is happening and all. Beautiful story. It will tell you where is red, where is green, where is red, what do you want. If you take care of at least 60% of their observations, you are pretty safe into your operations. Read that early watch report. Beautiful reports. I mean, SAP has written very beautiful reports. If you look at what kind of benefits other than incident management we are doing from enterprise services, we make very good use of EGI. Now, what is happening through EGI is the cost on the consulting is reducing. For example, Fiori implementation, right? We did through EGI. This is expert guided implementation. They will take 4 or 5 sessions on different days, right? A team will sit. He will tell you something, you go to your desk, perform some things, come next day, again lecture, again lecture, again lecture and all. This is so Fury, we did that way, and Solution Manager Technical Dashboard, we did through AGI. Then CQC, these services, 6 and 7 services by default will take from these things. Real good value addition from SAP as far as these are. And then early watch report, at least I am really sold to this. I don't know who has designed this report. Beautiful technical inputs. Again, I am repeating, I am really sold to this early watch report. You must read it. They have started a new service, OpenSAP. I don't know whether you have done it or not. Yesterday, there was a lecture on digital transformation. There's a course. You will get a certification also. Have you attended that? You attended that. So beautiful. I think they have already announced 7-8 series, right? So you just go to that. They will give you a certificate. First lecture was very, very good. It really told you what digital transformation talking in and how SAP is taking it. OSS, definitely everybody knows. Though we are giving good money on enterprise support services to SAP, but we hardly send about 180 to 200 messages in a year for OSS. The rest we tackle at our support desk. We are of the opinion, at least I am the opinion, doesn't matter if we are giving money to IOCA, my people should be able to resolve each and every problem at their desk. Why to OSS? That's why each and every upgrade, each and every implementation, I think for the last 10 years, we have not hired any consulting. The entire technical team, 2 people are sitting here. Three people are sitting here. So they do themselves here. Themselves, all upgrades. Yes, backend, you have got an enterprise support services. Early watch checks, go live checks, before live checks. We consult them, what is to be done. You give us the notes. For example, we have already started reading the notes on Oracle 12c. I think we will be the first one, if I'm not wrong, to shift to Oracle 12c. You have already done it, very nice. So we'll take your advantage of that. So a lot of notes have already come. Beautiful notes, you go through that and all those things will tell you what is to be done and all. So this is what. SAP Marketplace is just like a mall. You know, I mean, if you go to Marketplace, you will not come out after 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. So much masala you will get onto this. Anything you want to know about it, you will get it here. Go live checks, yes, we make it mandatory. Any upgrades we are doing, any small functionality, big functionality, we tell them to do the go. Sometimes they are hesitant, why so much, but we make it sure we do it. The year starts with enterprise support services by making a yearly plan. We tell them, look, this is our motive, this is what my business goal, this is what innovation I want to do it. So they come and sit with us, that is what we are doing for it. Indus, definitely a source of good information for us. We have got in oil and gas chapter. Tomorrow we have a meeting of oil and gas at HMEL. They are doing a lot of good lectures for us, how mobile is working and all those things. We are a good partner, ramp-up partner for SAP, specifically in sales and distribution SD module with SAP works as a ramp-up partner. We do some value engineering workshops with them. What we are doing, what is the value, how much we are doing, how to benchmark yourself with the peers, that kind of a study, not very often, but sometimes we do, where do we stand about it. I don't know whether they will like it or not. We have a luxury of having a dedicated support advisor also. So I need not talk to anybody. I'll just talk to this guy. Look, I have sent an OSS. I have not got a reply for so many hours or so many. This person basically helps us remotely to get the message accelerated. And finally, it comes to her. I mean, this is how it works. We conduct a lot of workshops in-house, in our premises, as well as in SAP, for example, GST, Fury, and all those things, about 6, 7, 8 workshops in a year we do with them. We request them, they come at half-day work session. This is how Fury, we did a lot of 3 or 4 workshops with them. SCN network, definitely everybody knows, it's a good network for technical people and all. And we have got a liberty go to SAP Gurgaon Center. They have got plenty of SAP press books, right? So if anybody wants to know something about it, we give them 1 day paid leave and they go to SAP office and read the SAP press books. This is how do we, keep ourselves updated. If I'm not wrong, again, we are the only company in India who has got 5 times ACE awards. I don't know about maybe I may be wrong. We have got 5 ACE awards from SAP. This is the 4-time CCO certification we have got. And this year we are targeted. We have already applied for CCOE of the world. For the universe, and 3-4 national e-governance awards we have got. So this is all from my side.
Thanks a lot. So let me absorb some of the content that you have shared and then come back to you. Meanwhile, I'll ask Uma. See, Deepak already shared a lot about some of the support services that SAP provides as part of enterprise support, right? So now, is that all that customers get, or is there a way for customers to get involved at a slightly more deeper level as well?
Yeah, Mr. Deepak covered quite a lot with respect to what you get from a regular run point of view, but what is more important is also that there's an opportunity to influence. And that is where we would like to see Indus participate more and more, to really see that Indus is able to contribute in terms of participating in customer validation, where they can come to SAP site, work with us, validate the products which are going out of the market. And also there's an opportunity for Indus to work with us in terms of helping us define the roadmap, because we have a beautiful program called Influencing at SAP, where you could come in and you could provide, okay, these are the ideas which we would like to see. And of course, there's a prioritization voting mechanism available. And based on the votes and the feasibility, we consider this for the future roles. So definitely, we would like to see more involvement from Indus in terms of getting engaged and to really contribute to the future roadmap of SAP, because we have declared that we will maintain the current business unit until 2025. Of course, we will see a lot of our customers also move into our S/4HANA roadmap. But at the same time, we promise that whatever we bring in terms of user experience innovation, like what HMEL suggested in terms of the Fiori, we will also bring that into our business suite environment, and we would really like to see how we can work with you to make that even more usable for you. So you have much more coming than just the services by being part of the enterprise support.
Interesting. So let's just get a little more strategic here. So can you just share with us some amount of or maybe, you know, a peek into the maintenance strategy of SAP?
So what SAP has recognized is our customers have huge and very complex landscape, and we really would like to ensure that you have the return on investment for all the operations that you have put in place to really run the system. That is why we declared that we will maintain our current releases until 2025. What this means is not only that you get the incidents resolved or the support packs and the legal changes, but we also provide incremental innovation on a continuous basis. I'm happy to see that IOCL is at EHP7 next year. Around April time frame, we will come with the next EHPs, and we also would have future EHPs also for the business unit, not just for S/4HANA, where we will come with incremental innovation. So definitely, we expect that our customers will continue to be in the suite landscape as well as move into the S/4HANA landscapes with different speeds. And we would like to enable each and every one of our customers to take the journey at their pace.
Interesting. So what Deepak covered, a lot of, or rather most of these services that Deepak covered in his presentation, was also things that customers request, right? So they need to first find out information about that and then request. So it's more reactive support from our side. So are there things that we do from a proactive support?
There are certain things which we are working from a proactive point of view. This is more from an incident handling or a message solving point of view, which you would have probably heard during lunchtime. I heard some of your colleagues talk to me where we said it would be nice for us to know if, let's say, HMEL reported some issue and we had given a solution that others can also see it. Obviously not so showing which customer had the problem or what was the issue. So what we are coming up with is a set of knowledge base articles which will be available for customers just on Google search. So these articles will, today you can search them on your service portal, but what will happen tomorrow is even when you do a Google search, these articles will come up, which will make it a lot more easier for your people, your IT people, to find these knowledge articles which will solve most of the problems. The other facility that we are going to introduce but not yet introduced is a chat facility, because today you go and send a message and hope that somebody returns, but over a period of the next months, there will be an opportunity to chat with a support person where you can ask a question, get an answer, and if this is not getting resolved, then decide to create an incident on BCP. There would also be an opportunity to schedule a session with an expert if you have a much more detailed question. So these are some of the peek into what is coming from a proactive point of view in the future.
Interesting. So I'll come back to you, Deepak. From a from a recommendation perspective, okay, so if you were to recommend, let's say, 1, 2, or 3 services that every customer we have his room should definitely explore and use, what would those 1, 2, 3 services be?
See, as I was telling in my presentation, services is okay, but certain things which are mandatory which one should do is, you should try for CCO certification. It really keeps your house in order. All processes get streamlined. One is CCOE. Second is, bring a regular habit of reading the early watch report. It tells you so much about your systems. CQC, definitely, if you, there are certain CQC services, for example, if you are from moving from EHP 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, there is a function, I mean, the CQC service which you can run yourself, or SAP runs it, within 24 hours, they give you the results. This was in EHP 6, and this is what the new facility is in EHP 7. This is one of the services. But as far as the, we do a custom code manageability, this is the one service which we do every year. It tells us basically what was the custom programs which remain untouched for a year, and we take a decision onto that. We do security optimization. This is the second service regularly we take. There are other services like business planning and monitoring, because you know, you have to do the office work also, because everything, if you, because it requires a lot of time also. If you get involved into the CQC, SAP is definitely there, but it involves your time also. So you have to see, you have to keep a balance. What are all the things, if I just request to SAP and within 24 hours I'll get the services. So DVM is one, how your data growth is happening. Custom code maintainability is one. Security optimization is one. The new functionality in EHP 7, and they call it a functional, some name is there, that is there. Otherwise, there are so many new services are there which requires functional people involvement. You can pick up any business process and you can put it into the Solution Manager 7.1. I was Control Center of Innovation, I was talking to you. You can put it there, you can see where is the problem, the root cause analysis, but somebody has to sit. Somebody has to get it configured. With SAP, you have to work it. So a lot of good services are there. If you ask your support advisor, they will, or you go to marketplace, you will get the entire 16-17 CQC services list is available there. Choose and do that. So CQC is one. Webinar, I will tell, yes, you should take out some time. Not always. If you find you are getting a mail, one or two webinars you should definitely attend. EGI is a wonderful thing I am telling you. As I told you, my Fiori implementation, my Solution Manager technical dashboard, we got it done through EGI only. I mean, about 4 to 5 sessions, if I'm not wrong, right, per these things, and we were able to do this. So entire Fiori, we are doing it ourselves. I don't know other people will be doing it, but this is how we are doing it. So our cost of consulting has drastically reduced now because most of the things, enterprise support services is happening that way. Now, we are very, very seriously looking, I mean, how you help the customers on IoT field, actually. Some webinars, some services and all, I mean, that's the thing which we are looking into that.
Super. So I open it up for questions. If there are any questions, we can take them now. Yeah, can someone give a mic there, please? So in the interest of time, we will limit to 3 or maybe 4 questions.
Hi, my name is Vikram. My question is basically that you have Fiori as well as Persona.
Fiori
and Persona. You have implemented both in IOCL.
No, we have Persona, we have not implemented. Oh, we have done some pilot testing at our place.
Okay.
So, some 2 or 3 screens we have done it. Mm-hmm. So we'll rolling it down. But just testing we have done, it works. Persona works.
We are also on the same page, actually. We are also trying to roll out Persona in near future. My question was that, is there any strategy that you have started working on that this particular transaction should be on Fiori and this particular transaction should be on Persona?
One thing, we are very clear on strategy. If any mobile applications which is going to pull data from SAP, we are going to develop on Fiori. Why? Because today Fiori client is available on Android store, on your Apple store, as well as Windows store. So you just load a client. Already, I mean, if you load a, I mean, you just download the client onto these things, you can get access to the SAP services. Call is to be taken. If the database is other than SAP, whether you should really stick to Fiori or not, as I told you, 1 or 2 applications we made on Oracle, MAF also, right? As an application, we have launched it, not as a client. As an application, we have launched it. So we are just taking this thing. Right now, our mobile applications are limited to SAP only, and the personal choice is Fiori only. It's a good, everybody is liking it. Everybody, the tile-based system, the appearance, and because we already gained the expertise of doing it, it is available on all the 3 forms, this thing, Android, Apple, as well as Windows. So we are happy with that.
Okay.
I think maybe I can quickly add, basically, you know, normally you use personas because UiFi and Fiori cannot do everything that yes. a WebDAV Pro ABAP can do. So it depends on how complex your transaction is and how many fields, how many tabs you need to show, what information you need to show. So you base that to decide whether you're going for a persona or a Fiori.
Or even the first screen itself you can try. I mean, just to modify the without transaction, I mean, you can have good pictures and of your choice, you know, I mean, you, that you can do it.
Thank you. So I have another question.
You have? I'll just. On the ESS, just want to know, is it that all customers can avail, like all of them, like CQC and security optimization, or
yes.
is there some?
All customers can avail.
Okay, so there's no limitation. Just because they are big enough, you're supporting. There's no such thing.
No.
Okay, thank you.
Basically, going back to persona vis-a-vis Fiori, so my question to Uma is, what is SAP's roadmap? How you see? Because off late, we got an impression that, you know, persona is sort of taking somewhat backseat.
See, we are giving persona to the customer to look at it. If you see the SAP UX strategy, which is also put in the SAP SAPedia and UX Explorer, it is very clear. New, renew, and enable. New means anything which is newly developed. We are doing a lot of design thinking with our end users, and we are developing it in Fiori. For defined casual user transactions, where we feel that it can be implemented in Fiori and can be made device agnostic, we are using the renew phase. That is where you saw most of the other things like the travel apps or the HCM apps or the purchase order, requisition, purchase order approval, those screens which are falling into the renew. Actually, I think in the earlier presentation you heard 25 Fiori apps. Right now we have roughly about 300 Fiori apps which are already there. And then we leave the enable space for personas, because persona as a framework is available, and we leave it for the customers to decide where they want to use that. And we do not, we invest on the framework, but not on creating the persona screens itself.
And so I just add it here, to take the maximum benefit of Fiori application, if you have used the SAP standard, right, then you can take a good benefit of Fiori. If you have done customization, field changes, and all those things, you have to rewrite a code. You have to rewrite a code ABAP, bring you to the OO data. But yes, UI5 interface will be utilizing of Fiori and putting into that. So it all depends what kind of a implementation you have done.
So and
how
SAP
close you are to SAP standard.
And SAP's UX strategy is also available online. You can actually download the entire document. If you want to influence, you can participate in the influence programs that are run for UX influencing as well. So, and Indus participates. Indus can participate. Indus members can participate in those influence programs as well. So one last question, otherwise we kind of move to the next or the last topic of the day. No? Okay. So thanks
thank
a
you.
Lot.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Deepak. Thank you. Thanks, Deepak.